Hello everybody, Gerone Wright here, and once again you're joining me on my Gerone Wright YouTube channel here on YouTube. Okay, you're looking at a mirrored image of the Under Armour insignia that appears on the clothing that you buy that's created by Under Armour or whoever owns that line of clothing. All right, which I didn't even bother to check. We can do that down the line. I'm just right now concentrating on pumping these videos out through my paranormal experience and encounter. How I arrived at this Under Armour gear is that I received a gift from my gal pal, who I identify as JS. So I want to thank her for getting me this hoodie. At first I was reluctant to take it because I really don't take gifts, people, and But anyway, she gave me this hoodie, and I'm gonna see if I can just bring up just a piece of it here. This is the hoodie. I don't know if you can actually see it. Okay, and let me see if I can put the Under Armour. I don't know what you can see or can't see, but there's the Under Armour logo on it there, and this is inside of the hoodie, the camouflage that there, and this is the insignia on the front there. You see that? That's what the front part of it looks like. That's on the chest part. Okay, it's a extra large hoodie, black hoodie, and you know, on face this does not appear to be anything. It just seems to be a natural hoodie, and it has a natural insignia on the front of it, which is like a camouflage insignia, so you don't pay attention to it. So her and her mom insisted that I try it on. I'm out in the front of my house, so I tried it on, and I was in the process of leaving anyway and going to the parts store. So what I actually did is I tried it on over top of a shirt that I had, and then after I tried it on, it fit. It was nice. They liked it, and I liked it. I just threw it on the front seat of my vehicle, and I proceeded to drive on. So, you know, I never see anything normally anymore, not through my experience and encounter, my paranormal experience and encounter, which allows me to sense, feel, and see anything multidimensional around me, and especially if it relates to who we genetically are and how we genetically evolved as what we've become today. So as I'm driving down the road, I mean, I cut my eye over to the sweater, and I look at the logo on the chest of this sweater, and I'm looking right straight in the face of a serpent, of a snake. And I know that this is not something that, I mean, would be seen, because you're not looking at this. I'm not looking at the sweater in an upright position. I'm actually looking at it like from an upside down, off to the side, a crossed angle position. So wearing this sweater normally, one would never even see that there is a snake on there. So as I come to a stop, I look at the head of the serpent, which is the snake, and I follow it up to see where the rest of the body goes, and I'm starting to see faces of apes and everything else. I'm saying, wow, this is amazing. Well, because I know that this is a discovery, because I know that through the body of the snake and the serpents and the reptiles and the apes, I know that mankind evolved. I know our evolutionary passage. So therefore, I know that these things are attaching something far greater. So I'm going to show you on that insignia. Now, I'm going to turn it up sideways. Now, I have to turn this in a position that this is not the way that this is supposed to be viewed. It's supposed to be viewed turned over this way, like straight, you know what I mean, like parallel. Now, I'm turning it up here in this angle to show you. Now, if you look, I'm going to see if I can find the head of it. Okay, there's the head of the snake there. I'm going to have to get me a pointer. If you look on this here, there is the eye right there of the snake, the eyebrow, that distinct eye, that the way the snake eye. Here is the mouth of the snake, the mouth line, the nose of the snake, and there is the head of the snake, and it comes up and it starts attaching, and you can even see actually a likeness of a man's face right there, right here. I'm seeing it now through the back and all, almost like a bearded man right in there. But I'm going to show you the ape figures and all of that, because they're a reptilian ape and an ape as we would know it today. They're all encrypted and encoded in here. All right, but there's the face of the snake there. And people, I mean, this is just truly amazing, because the nostrils there, and I have it drawn out on paper as well too. But I mean, no one would actually suspect that as being there, because you're wearing this thing in an upright position, which would be in this direction. I mean, a person would not buy this if they knew that there is an option of that they have a snake on it. You would not see that like this. And this is foliage. I mean, this is out in the wilderness. This is camouflage. You would never think that that was up in there. But there is a host of creatures that are encrypted in there, which is implying these cult-like scenarios where these animals genetically contributed to mankind, and the success on logos and clothing brands like this is based on this underlining cult message. But it's amazing because how they slip these things into us underneath the radar. And again, with a bunch of leaves and something from out in the wilderness. I mean, you would never think that that stuff is in there, especially if you can't see it. But let me show you the drawing that I actually have, that I made. If I can find it now. Okay. The snake head runs off of the page. But I'm going to see if I can bring this up to you and show you how this actually works. Now, and I might have to get my board. I'm going to show you how this actually works. The snake head runs off the page down here. Down there. All right. But there's that eye I was telling you about. Even the nostril is right there at the tip. This is the mouth area. But look at how this is distinct of how the eye of the snake, which is consistent with a reptilian, that sly look almost like a crocodile. You see that? That bump, that over top of the eye up in there. And then when the body's coming around, check this out. Oh, by the way, the snake is in the mouth of an ape figure. This whole line here creates that of the, I'm over the cranial. This is the nose area of the ape. Here's the cranial. And even the eyes of the ape, those beady eyes with the brows. You know what I mean? With the distinct like bone over top of the eyes. All of these distinct features are there. And it's not just one, but it's multidimensional. Then over here, you have a similar thing. This is the reptilian ape that I'm telling you about that's off to the side. And it actually has, it's showing you DNA in its mouth, showing you the distinction of all of these genes and how they cause for the likeness of mankind. Now, I've already shown you a man image that is also in here as well, too. So you have multidimensional images, which are in images, and depending on the resolution and the way that you're looking at it, these images are appearing. But this, I mean, people, this is crazy. Now, Mike, my mirroring guy, he mirrored the image for me. And when he mirrored it, he produced several other images. Now, I don't know if I can bring this in close enough for you to see. This is the only thing about this, because we're going screen against screen here, almost. Let me see if I can bring this up to show you some of the things that are here. Mike mirrored this for me. And people, here is a Medusa-like figure. I mean, there is a face, there's the mouth, there's the eye. Look, you even have lines coming up. I mean, I'm going to get this in closer. Hold on. I can possibly bring that up. I'm going to bring this in closer because some of you will see this. This is a mirrored image of that logo, of that body, I mean, of that, what is that? Armour underwear logo. And let me see. And we're going to need to zoom in. How come my zoom in feature didn't come up? Wait, you want to act up on me now? Where is my zoom in feature? I clicked it, but it didn't. Oh, shoot. Come on. Now the computer wants to act up. All right, we're gonna go there again. Well, okay, that's not zooming in for whatever reason. I'm not gonna sit there and play with it. If it wanna be stubborn, fine. I'm gonna get it regardless. Maybe it's these beans that are there. I'm gonna bring this in as close as possible because I am right there. Now, I don't know if you guys can see it or not. I know if I come in too close that you won't be able to see anything. But let me see. I have it tilted back. Let me see what we got there. I'm gonna bring that in as close like that. Okay, and hold it up. Alright. I know that this is gonna be hard. People up in here, there's a face with snakes coming off the head like that of Medusa. Okay? The face is up in there. Alright, a witch-like woman. And then, but look at that, people. There's a person sitting here, cross-legged right there. I'm gonna set this down now so I can see what I'm looking at. And I'm gonna tell you what this is. What this is almost, look, there's a person sitting here with their legs like toward the cross, like a Buddha-like person, with the head here. And people, you know what this is? This is implying, what this entire thing is implying here. How they ended up doing these mirrored images how they ended up doing this, how this clothing design came out, and they used almost like outdoor woods to create these images. You know what this is? You ever see those, I know you'd have seen them, the glass. It reminded me of that stained glass in ancient rooted religion. Where in those churches, those ancient Gothic buildings where you have the glass cutoffs, that's what this is. This is how they created these encrypted clothing lines right here. And I forget what you call that glass, that ancient stained glass where they create the pictures in it. I forget the specific name for it. It escapes me and eludes me at this time. But people, that's what this is. This is. This is the same exact encryption style that is utilized in those ancient glass where they have religious figures on them. And I have a video on that as well here too, people. But that's what's being shown. Now, I don't know if you can see this guy's face right here. Am I in too close? Oh, God. I don't know if you're going to be able to see the face. There's a face in here, people, that's looking at me. Mouth, eye. And then it goes off to other faces, off to the side. And then there's faces in there. Multi-dimensional images that are staring at you. That puts, when whoever wears these clothings, this clothing line, it puts a claim on your being. Not only on your physical and being in reality the way you are now, but in spiritual. You know what I mean? Imagine you passing over again. You're dying and you have this clothing and logo on your body. And then you turn around and you pass away. And what this all stands for is the collection plate for them coming to get your soul. Soul sending devices that you know nothing about, regardless of your religious affiliation, whether you're Muslim, whether you're Christian, whether you're anything, these devices are in place, these insignias that puts a logo on you. You're wearing this on your chest like Batman or Superman. So when you pass away, what do you think is going to happen? You are claimed by this logo, which is put out by Armour Underwear. I'm not saying this shit right. Under Armour. I gotta write that down. Under Armour. Alright. So, now, I want to show you something about this insignia. Again, this is the way you're supposed to be looking at it, like this here. Now, I'm going to turn it to show you where my ape and this is the chest of that. This is a copied chest plate of that. You probably seeing other things now that I didn't show it to you. You'll see all kinds of stuff with it being mirrored. Now, I'm going to turn that back up sideways so you can see that snake and ape. I'm going to hold it back because I was holding up kind of close there. See that ape there? And look at the other face coming off the side of that. And then it's the ape. Where the white snake, where the one ape is there, the snake is in the ape's mouth. and then the reptilian ape off to the side, and you probably see other images that I'm showing you this now. So these creatures are our earliest of ancestors. You know what I mean? So now I'm going to take you to this. I'm linking this to the success of Duck Dynasty. The success of Duck Dynasty is phenomenal. Also, A&E that televises them, Duck Dynasty brought ratings, record-breaking ratings, okay, to A&E. I'm stating that all of them are now guilty as charged as bringing these cult scenarios into our homes, into our lives, and into our imaginations. And it's a scenario that actually, it's almost like a soul claiming device. And I'm telling you that the success of Duck Dynasty is based on the underlining cult message that is actually there, used as vessels to bring into your minds and into our homes. And also the clothing line of that of Under Armour. This is what this is about. The success of these individuals is not based on, well, on their character, but it's the clothing line that backs them. And they're wearing the Under Armour clothing line, which I'm telling you, you take those clothes that they have on, and in mirrored images, they produce the cult-like images that I am describing to you, which actually implies genetic bridging and genetic manipulation. And it's a cauldron cult-like process, okay? And it's all about the underlying message that's in the clothing that they're wearing. And if you notice that all of them have either the insignia, the clothing, or something relating to Under Armour on their body. And this is based on, this is their success. This is the reason why these guys became so successful with their show. I'm gonna show you something else. Their appearance. Oh, I have other images up here. I'm gonna flick through some of these images up here on my screen. All right, I'm gonna flick through some of the images up here on my screen because I'm gonna go to the image of their images talking about. Oh, now this wants to come up. Now my. What the hell? What the heck? What's going on now? I done lost where I was. This is crazy. Hold on, people. I gotta take this off right quick. Oh, gosh. This is crazy. How did this go? Alright, let me come back up. I have to take that off for a minute, people. Hold on. All right, I'm gonna go to something else here for a minute. All right, there's that Medusa looking woman again. You might be able to see that a little bit better there in this image over here. I'm gonna bring that in closer. Okay, I'm looking at it from here. There's her mouth, there's her nose, there's her eye, there's her eye. And you see these like snaky objects coming off of her head here, and it creates like to the top and on like a headpiece. And then there's another creature up in here. Can you see that up in there? And then down here, there's another face, a reptilian looking creature there, the mouth, the chin, the eye, the forehead, and its ears is created other heads facing off. And then look, there's other heads here. There's a chin, there's a mouth. Look at. It's wearing, I don't know if you can actually see it, but pieces of his ear is showing you other creatures on there, right there. I'm going to post these images on my Facebook page. as well. And what's going to end up happening is I'll highlight them on my Facebook page so they can be seen. And they'll also go to my Google Plus page, okay? So these images will go online and I'll highlight them better for you because I don't know what you can see on this screen here. So I'll highlight these images. And these creatures are mutations in sequential order that describes how mankind was actually created. Here's another mirrored image here by Mike. And in these windows, there are also different appearances. And I don't know if you can see that face up in there. Again, you might get like a glare or glow back. But there's a face up in there like the guy is in the prison between these branches here. You know what I mean? So all of this stuff is symbolizing who we genetically are, genetic extraction. Look at the Arab looking figure here, and he has a turban on his head, coming across his head. There's the chin, there's the mouth, there's the eye, there's it, and the turban wrapped around his head. These genes are describing genes from our ape and African ancestor, which I've already shown you there, reptiles. Then it's showing you our Egyptian ancestors. It's showing us, it's going from, it's making reference to Asian ancestors. And through each continent, to which actually calls for the likenesses of our Caucasian counterparts. This is what this is describing in sequential order. Again, this is how this is mirroring over different likenesses. These images will be up on my Facebook page, people. So basically, look at this here. I'm going to stop here for a minute. Can you see that? Look at that, people. This here, this style of this right here, is, look at this. There's a creature's head in there. Chin, mouth, eye, and look at this. You know what this design is right here? You know what this is right here? What this is created? This almost looks like a damn spaceship up here. But you know what this is? What this can be equated with right there? This is a cone-like, one of the cone-like pillars there at Angkor Wat at the top there. And I have a video on that as well too. But look at that. There's a head in there, and this being is like a throne, I mean, not a, like a crown being, but this is something that can be equated to those, not the pillar, the caps at Angkor Wat and the eaves. This is what this is showing me right here. And there's a being in the middle. People, I can make a whole new creation of art based on what is being shown here. This figure here, and not just that, other figures. And this is why art is so popular in our world today. You see all of these bizarre artworks and wondering what in the world, well, where did they get that idea from? All you have to do is download this app and take it to these people's art, and it reverses what they did, their art. Their art is based on them doing this and creating images and playing it back to you in the real-time sense, when it's actually a dimensional drawing that they took from someplace else and brought it into our time. That's what this is all about. So if you take everything, I don't care whether it's Disney, anything, and an imagery that you are suspicious of, or that you might feel that say, hey, there's something unusual about this, but I'm drawn into it. I want to know what it is. Take it, download the app. I'm gonna have the app up here, and you take and start mirroring these images and reflect them back. And what you can do is, especially animated stuff, doing it in an animated sense to where you can take it and reverse it backwards. Take an image in real time sense and then play it backwards. Just slide it back. And it'll start producing reality in the images of where the one that is being shown to you came from. I'm going to end up, I know that you probably can't see a lot of this. I'm going to have to break this down and put this on my page. But people, what I'm claiming here, I'm going to show you something about these Duck Dynasty characters too. I don't know if you can see this here, because here's some more images here. You might be able to see this. Here's one of the mirrored images, and it creates like a butterfly. Oh, you can see it there. There he is right there. Can you see that? Oh, okay, yes. Here. You see this guy right here? He has a crown. This creates a crown. A king's crown right there, okay? The crown is on the head of this being. There's his eye, and there's his eye. There's his mouth, and he has this scraggly beard. And this here is worn by this king-like figure as a wing. Now, even in there is my witch-like woman, who I dub as the mother of creation. Okay? Wherever she appears, this is signifying the cauldron, the cult. Her creator, the witch's brewing kettle. You know what I mean? But they're talking about genes, describing genes and genetics. This is what she's cooking up. So she's appearing with man's likeness, which is that of ape. All of that is here. Now, these are the wings, talking about these genetics. Right there. Now, I'm going to show you. Now, oh, by the way, people, again, back to our Duck Dynasty characters. That man's face in there. Are the faces and likenesses of these guys with their beards. Those Moses-like figures, those ancient Gothic-like figures where those hierarchy guys all had their beards out like that. This is what this is symbolic. This is symbolic of everything that is right here. The same exact thing. So it's too many ties to be overlooked on why these guys are being televised in that sense. And with that gear on, with the underlining messages, and it all, I'm telling you, is linked to something ancient rooted, which all is describing how mankind genetically evolved from one state of being to the next state of being. I'm looking at apes and everything else here. There's an ape there too, right there, people. I'm looking at the ape right there. And all of this here, I'm gonna post these images on my Facebook page and on Google Plus. You can get me there anywhere online. You'll see these pictures online. I'm also on Twitter. So when I link these images, when I send these images to either my Facebook page or to Google Plus, they also go to Twitter. I can upload them to Twitter. So you can go all there and get these images, people. But again, Here's one at the top of the butterfly, the one at the very top. It's a poor copy, but I'm going to give you an idea of, look at that face, and like look at this as a butterfly, first of all. Now, where the butterfly head would be at, and this, is they creating like an antenna? Where the butterfly head would be at right here. Look at the face as I come in, as it appears. Watch this. I'm going to try to turn it in a sense so you can see. See that face and eyes? See the distinct features of a face coming in? You see that? This, people, is describing ancient rooted genetics. Here's that king character right there. That's a piece of him. I just drew a couple lines in the face. My lines don't do nothing for the way the guy is actually is. But look, there he is there. Look. Look at this. My drawings don't do nothing for what is actually there. If you were to actually be here and see this, people, when I tell you that this is beyond comprehension, it really is. It's too much there to describe. When I'm telling you that there is a picture-perfect face of a king, and description and detail that I can't even give it all to you here. But people, there is so much, and it's in sequential order, and it's describing of who we are, how mankind has evolved through all of these creatures, which include dinosaurs, triceratops. You know, all of these things, people, it's all encrypted and included in this message board. These messaging boards describing who we genetically are and how we genetically evolve from one state of being to the next, to the next, to the next. And this is why we have all of these different strands of DNA in our bodies, and they're saying that 190 or 200 are not even utilized. People, they were already used. We evolved through a strand of creatures' genes and genetics that from each time to each time that they've been bridged over, They've been cut off. One became stronger than the next became stronger than... That's what this is about, them creating this cocktail of genes that battle out one gene to create another. People, I'm telling you that this is unusual and bizarre as it may sound. I need a team of experts because I'm going to tell you something. It's too much here for me to even with me trying to describe this to you, I'm all over the place. But I'm telling you that the message and the success of these people, of these Duck Dynasty characters, are based on their appearance with beings that we evolved through. Look at them. Then on top of that, people, take their success and then take the clothing that they're wearing. The clothing that they're wearing, it can be mirrored, and the truth comes out of it. I can even show you images and faces on the clothing without even mirroring them. But people, this is just camouflage clothing. So why is there, when you mirror it, the truth comes out on what they stand for? Now, another thing too, I want you to do. Google Duck Dynasty. Google Duck Dynasty. And when you Google the Duck Dynasty, like here, for instance, I don't know if you can see that figure here. I don't know where we're at here. Look, right? Hold on, let me hook this up. I'm going to show you something. I'm going to draw a face right here on this guy's criteria. I'm going to show you where it's at, and then I'm going to draw it. Like right here. Like right there. Look at the face right there at the point of my finger. Watch how I can make that come into play. If you take it is actually two faces. It's more than one. I'm gonna do the one. In fact, I'm gonna show you how this actually works. And it actually looks like a native face. I don't know if I can actually. I'm gonna accent it and highlight it. It's actually two faces. All right, I highlighted it some right there. Damn it, this is bugging me because I can't coming back in front of the screen like this. This is why I need tech support experts to help me do this. There go people that could probably, we can do this right on screen and not go through all of this, but let me see where we're at. But okay, I highlighted the face there. Now check this out, because I'm gonna point this to you. I'm gonna show you how these multi-dimensional images work. It doesn't just be one face, it be several faces. All right, hold on. Where we at with this guy? Okay, there's the one that I highlighted right here, right there. Now check this out, there's another one pointing up from there, from off of there. There's one here, and then there's one coming up this way. Let me see if I can capture the second one for you, where it starts at. And I'm gonna highlight it so I can see it better. All right. I just started it, because you can see the mouth turned up on the second face. All right, hold it. I just started it right there. Okay, here's the one face. Notice how that is looking like a jungle native right there. Look at this right here. And then the second face is merging up right here. I just highlighted it, coming upwards like that there. And then there's another one facing backwards. I'm gonna show you the one that's going backwards off of that. I'm gonna show you I can't actually do that. I'm not gonna do that one. But anyway, these mirrored images, if they're mirrored, it produces a truth and reality. Tell a story. It's a message board, a diagram which can be read. And this is what is happening here, people. It's showing genes and genetics. Again, this reminds me of ancient stained glass that are in church buildings. The way this is actually going, the reflections, the truth, and in fact, a lot of these images, if you look at it, this guy is looking straight Gothic right here. This is showing me a king figure here. All right, there's another face there. What I'm going to do is I'm gonna take and take these images and I'm gonna highlight them and I'm put them online and circulate them online so you'll be able to see exactly what I see. But it's showing me something, and I'm gonna tell you what this actually is implying. Notice, see how this king is upright, facing upright. You know what this, and you see the insignia here. You know what this is telling me right here. There's a black king here, and his crown is turned down. It's showing a black king's crown turned down to the white king's crown, showing you that these genes actually were bridged over with these genes, and it calls for this likeness, why this likeness here was extracted. So it's showing you a time before we, nothing, I mean, it's nothing in history that is describing anything that I am stating. It is showing you times of civilizations of people that we know nothing about. And it's all here referenced right here. In this mirrored image. It's crazy. My name is Gerone Wright. I'm going to let this go and all. People, what I need is a team of experts, mirroring experts, imaging experts, rather than mirroring, because my man Mike, I like to think that he's the best in the business. But what we need is, we need imaging experts. We need people on this that can actually, I can take and show them what is here, what is, have them speak for me, describe what I'm stating, take the genes and the genetics that I'm talking about, reverse these things step by step by step. We can start finding cures to medicine. We can actually start showing, corralling those people up that are guilty for genetically altering mankind's being and then pretending like they didn't know what the hell was going on. And I'm talking about ancient rooted religion and ancient rooted, I'm royalty and everybody else that are guilty of, because this is like a genocide against mankind. Introduction of animal genes into mankind's genes to genetically alter one being while destroying the next being. This is genocide. Those that have done this to us are guilty of, I'm telling you, the worst crimes against mankind that you can possibly ever imagine, because they have no care whatsoever for children, for mankind, for animal kind. People, this is something where these people have exposed us to something and knew all along what it was, and then are watching people die and suffer from bacterias and cancers and diseases that they created. A lot of this stuff that is being done, we will not even know the effects of it to still years down the lines. The effects, the causes and effects of this will be affecting us for the entire, I guess, for the entire evolution of mankind. This people take science and medicine in another entire different direction. But I'm telling you right now that those that have done this to us, you agree with them, these kingship, ancient rooted royalty and ancient rooted religion that's been around since the beginning of time. And again, these mirrored images and these artworks, they are guilty as charged because it appears in their works first. Again, the ancient rooted religion, they were actually the overseers of our world's first art. The artwork had to go through them in order before it even can be put into the mainstream. They governed that. So they know what this stuff is already. This is why this stuff is permitted today. They know what it is. This is what places a high value on these images, on these art creations. People, you take our world's most treasured art collection, start doing this to it, and it starts producing these multidimensional images. You don't have to know what they are. I know what they are. I know what they mean. It's an evolutionary step-up pattern, a pyramid pattern that describes where mankind came from. I know where they came from. I know where animal kind came. I can take it a step further, because what they don't know is that I know where all of this goes beyond that. so I can take us from the beginning. And what you don't understand here, people, in space, in nebulae gas matter, what's appearing here is appearing there. I can read through the fabric of space, through nebulae gas matter, where stars are supposed to be being created. There are holographic images that this stuff has, listen, is child's play compared to that. So, people, we have answers. You have to get me there to where we have a team, to where we can break this thing down, take charge of our own destinies, our own minds, and our own beings, and oust these people from who've been lying to us all along while destroying the true existence of mankind's form. These people are taking and making the image of man in their own design based on their own sick thoughts on what they think it should be. And while doing it to you under the guise of you worshiping them through religion and royalty. These people are demanding you worship them or else. You do, I'm not trying to change your mind. I'm not trying to do this. I'm not trying to do nothing. But I'm telling you right now that I should not be able to be showing you faces of apes and faces of kings and queens in a mirrored image of this, of a shirt that you buy in a store that you look like you don't have nothing on. It's almost like you're going to go take a leaf off your tree out in your yard and come to find out that on that leaf it has a face of a king, a queen, an ape, a snake. It has a texture. It has a messaging board on it. That wouldn't be the case, but what is the case is that something that you think is just plain with nothing on it, it's just, well, okay, this is an innocent shirt. I can go buy this for my son or for my daughter. This doesn't have nothing on it. There's no writing. There's no nothing. All it is just showing camouflage with that of outside with vegetation. That's it. I can go with this. I don't know what the insignia on there means, but I mean, I'm okay with that because it can't be too harmful. But yet when you start going and twisting that thing around and moving it around and flexing it around, it creates a motion picture of something far more demonic than you would like to be associated with. And it's being played on A&E television on a popular, these guys have become so popular that it's uncanny. You know why? Because of their cult affiliation. Through the clothing that they're wearing, through the images that they're portraying, it's all cult related. And this is why they're so popular. So you have A&E television, you have Under Armour clothing line, another famous, and then you have Duck Dynasty, they're famous. A&E became famous, well, A&E was already famous, but they became even more famous once they started airing Duck Dynasty. Duck Dynasty is stupidly famous. And then you got Under Armour clothing, which is famous, all now tied to something called that is genetically altering the man, the being of a man's kind being, the existence of mankind's being. Being televised on TV. No different than if you were to take and open up your door through your television dimensionally and say, come on in, everybody, come on in. All these demonic existences, all of these affiliations that you do not want to be associated with because you're a good Christian, are you a good Muslim, are you a good Jewish worshiping person, are you a good anything, any type of belief that you have, okay. You don't believe in none of that stuff, but you're letting it allowed it in because you know why? Through the underlining images of everything that you don't stand for, it's coming in. I don't worship no king over in Great Britain. I don't worship no King George or any other king from the ancient past. But yet when you look at this, what you don't know is that their images are being portrayed to you in underlining messages because there's these images. So whether you worship a king or queen or not, they done found a way to come into your home through your television, through the clothing that you wear. They're attaching you. Now, there's more to this than you could ever imagine because I found dimensional doorways right in our world. I got to get around to doing a video on that, people, because I want you to know where these dimensional doorways are. So you will have an option of whether you want to go through that doorway in your time of passing or not. I know where dimensional doorways are, how they were placed there, where you're going to be going. There's celestial alignments with these dimensional doorways. People, this goes beyond. There's no end to what this is actually entailing. I'm going to get off these images for a minute, but I'm going to tell you something now, people. We have a lot to realize. There's some smart people out there in this world today, and I'm telling you right now, look at my other videos that I have here. Look at my other videos. See where I'm going with this. I mean, I may not be the best narrator for this, but my messages are always true and correct. We're being commercialized with a market that is targeted at selling us, not just selling us the clothing, and they're selling our souls as well, too. They're claiming our souls. They're attaching our souls to the items that we are wearing. And that's what the bigger picture of this is. I'm talking about from dollar store items, from things that cost a penny, to those all up to the cost millions of dollars. People, you are in deep, deep, deep crap. Our world as a team, the masses of people as a whole, can pull us up out of this. Start opening up your eyes, people. My name is Gerone Wright. I'm going to let this video go. And what I'm telling you is that I'm claiming that Under Armour, that famous brand of clothing, Under Armour, I'm telling you that Duck Dynasty, their image, the clothing that they're wearing, the people behind Under Armour, I'm telling you that A&E Television is televising all of this, are all guilty of attaching a cult message to our minds and bringing the message into our homes, to our children, and globally saturating or contaminating us genetically. This is what this is all about. My name is Gerone Wright. I'm going to let this just go.